Lines on the table and boredom in my mouth.
It's catchy, heavy, dark pop that sums up having a midlife crisis at age 21 that Upsile does so perfectly. The EP is called Young Life Crisis.
I was just, at the start of the year, recognized that my life was sort of falling apart. I had this like very conscious decision where I was like, if I book myself in sessions all day long, do 3 sessions a day on Zoom, I won't have to deal with my issues and all. Like, just jacked all the time. So I was just kind of writing all of these songs every day. And then in July, I had just gotten back to LA, was on a session with this guy, Dwilly. I was just listing off all my life issues. And he was like, yeah, it sounds like you're having a bit of a young life crisis right now. And I was like, that just explained everything. And then when that was like the last song we wrote for the EP was that. And it just was this moment of clarity where I was like, I think I just accidentally narrated my life falling apart on an EP. No matter what age you are, everyone's experienced what you said, an existential crisis this year. So hopefully everyone will find a little bit of themselves in one or two of the songs, you know?
Absolutely. And I really did. And I even found it in, you know, in Money on My Mind, which I suppose if you consider the EP to be about life falling apart, that's kind of like an anthem to get shit back together again for yourself, right?
Totally. Yeah. I mean, I feel like whenever I'm coming out of a low point or I'm like on the up and up, it's such a roller coaster. Like some days you're like kind of going insane and you're like, I'm the shit. I got this. I'm a badass. And then other days it's the total opposite. But when I do have those little moments where I like feel like the baddest bitch on the planet, there's this magical energy about it, whether it's for like literally 30 seconds and then you're back to being sad, or it's a whole day or whatever. There's this magical feeling, and I wanted Money on My Mind to embody that whole feeling. And I feel like Money on My Mind is the most like positive bad bitch energy song on the EP. So I'm glad. I feel like it's a good balance to everything else that's happening on the EP.
Absolutely. But then obviously we do get into the slightly more, you know, intense matter. Have you always been good at talking about your emotions and talking about the stuff you're going through, or has that been something you've had to learn in the last few years?
I feel like it kind of, again, like happened on accident, because songwriting for me is so like therapeutic. Most days I write songs instead of going to therapy, which I should probably do, but like I'll just kind of go, and a lot of the times you're writing with like strangers sometimes, so like I find it so easy to just completely open up to someone who like I have just met on Zoom. I'm like, let me tell you about this issue that's happening in my life. And then for me, it really is like putting my feelings into a song is like what helps me get over things. For me, it's just has kind of happened. And then it just so happens that now these songs that were very much just like an emotional, that I wrote in a very emotional headspace, are now going to be out in the world. So I'm a bit nervous for people to hear it, because this one is a lot heavier than my last EP or other music I've put out. But it's like a new side of me that I'm hoping people will relate to, you know.
There's something about you that I'm just like, this is just going to connect with people straight away.
Oh, thank you.
Not everyone that can get themselves to a point where, you know, what you see is what you get straight away. People will take time to rip the little bits off them, the little band-aids off, and finally, you know, 5-6 albums later, you actually get the real them. But for you, I feel like it's all on the forefront, which leads me to the question, what happens next? If you are already at the point of telling everyone every little secret, what else? What else can we learn about you in the future?
More shit's going to go down in my life and everyone's going to get to hear about it, I guess. I mean, I'm only 20. I'm almost 22. I'm a completely different person now than I was at the start of 2020. My music is different. I could only hope that a year from today, I'll be a completely different person and my music will be different. I feel like my mind changes every day and like my feelings change every day. My relationships, friendships change. So my music naturally is just going to change with that. So there will be plenty more drama for y'all to hear about for sure.
Bring on the drama, baby.
We
live for the drama. No, I feel lucky because we get to grow up with you and we get to like hear you along the journey. And I hope you're able to keep a little bit for yourself as well and keep a little bit in here, just like a little the locket of sorts.
100%. I love it.
Yeah. Another necklace that you can
I'll add a little locket. Done.
Love it. Psyched for people to hear this. And thank you so much for chatting today. I think you're a really cool pop star and I'm really excited to see what happens.
You're dope. Thank you so much for doing this.